Well, this is Mick Pavey at DIY Investors doing a short video cast today on Thursday the 11th of February. It's been an interesting few weeks since the start of the new year, and here we are looking at the All Share Index, which as you can see started the year at 3,444. That's marked by the horizontal green line there, and it's been a pretty rough ride. We had a biggish dip through to about 21st of January, back up a little bit, didn't get through the 50-day moving average marked by the blue line there, and then it's dropped away again. But what I'm particularly intrigued about is that today on the 11th it's closed below a fairly significant line of support marked by this magenta horizontal line. So let's just take a little look and try and get a feel for what's going on here. And to do that, we need to go out to a slightly longer time scale. So if I double click and go out longer, in fact I've got even longer than that, you remember I did this before, where I took a vertical bar and I looked at the furthest distance that the index moved from the 200-day moving average. So you can see if I position the bar there, that the top of it on the resting on 200-day moving average, and the bottom of marks the sort of low point of the actual individual reading of the All Share Index back in this decline from 2008 to 2009. And if I just grab that bar and slide it across to the left, you remember we looked at this point over here in the post-millennium sort of slide, when it went from about 3,200 all the way down to about 1,600, the All Share Index, and it didn't actually go quite as far below the 200-day moving average. Anyway, this is quite a useful sort of marker, because it helps us get a feel for, you know, if you like, the maximum amount of distance that we're likely to get based on history, if you like, of the performance of the All Share Index. And it's just another way of trying to gauge where we are in the cycle, if you like. And if let's just go back and find that bar again and position it where I can actually make use of it up here, and come up and look at what's happening now. So you can see that if I position the top of it on the 200-day moving average about there, you can see that where we are now, although it's I was hoping that that line would be support. Today the index has dropped significantly below that line, and there's not a lot of support lines. That blue one there is not a particularly strong line. The next really strong support level is likely to be this downward sloping line that was previously resistance. It was resistance for quite a while, and those of you that have been around for a while with DIY Investors will remember that when it broke that line, I said that was significant on the way up. And I think that it's likely to mean that there's not a lot of support for the index in this current decline until we get down to around about an index level of 2,800, give or take a bit. Now, it could be that it'll be an intraday level, and it could be that that level itself won't offer enough support. And if you take the length of this blue line being the marker for the previous distance that we've dropped below the 200-day moving average before, then we could be down to these support lines down here around 2,562 or 2,486. So that would be, if you like, the next levels of support. But I'm rather hoping that this sloping line marked in the sort of orange colour here would be the logical place for support. So it's worth just looking at the relative strength index, the indicator down the bottom here, because if I just open that up so that you can see where we are, well, what we've actually got is a positive divergence, in fact. So we've got slightly contrary indicators, and here I'll take that bar and perhaps indicate with a line. Let me just mark a line for you to show you what I mean. Here we go. If I just take a line there somewhere, and make sure I'll just change the color of that and make it a perhaps a bit more bold so that you can see the point I'm trying to make. And there we go. So this line here, where I've just is showing that the RSI, the RSI level is not as low as it has been in going back last summer, and yet the index is lower. So the index lower and the RSI higher. So if you draw a line, if you like, that downward sloping line of the index and the upward sloping line of the RSI could be a positive divergence in the RSI, which could be sort of indicating that we're coming towards the end of the downward trend in the index. Now, of course, there's always two ways of looking at these things, because you could say, well, hang about, if we just take that line away a minute, let me just grab that and slide it out of the way. The RSI isn't oversold yet, so the index could carry on going down until the RSI gets down around this sort of level of 20 odd, certainly lower than 30, before it gets towards the oversold territory. So the RSI, if you read it by itself, is indicating not quite in oversold territory. And again, you have to determine, you know, how you read that. But my reading of it is actually that the index may go further down because it's broken that significant level of support there. And if you go back across to 2012, I'll just come in a bit closer and drop the RSI down again. You can see that this magenta line had been resistance 1, 2, 3, 4. It sort of was broken on the fifth attempt, and yet on the way down, the index, the all share index, has gone straight through it, like almost like a knife through butter, and finished significantly below it. And that gives cause for concern, and it's, you know, we're likely to see these sort of oscillations. There's a tremendous amount of volatility really since the beginning of December, and I can't see that changing in the near term. So whilst it might go back up, it's almost certain to come back down below and test that lower level that I was talking about. So that's my thoughts this Thursday evening, looking at the all share index. As ever, feel free to send me your comments or agree or disagree, but I just thought I'd show you two or three different ways of looking at this, taking into account longer trends and also looking at the possibility of a positive divergence on the RSI, or an alternative way of looking at it, that maybe the RSI isn't yet in oversold territory. So I'll stop there, and like you, I'll be watching the index with a great deal of interest in the next few weeks. So it's Mick Pavey at DIY Investors closing this short video cast.